Hey everyone, this is Mario with TCG Portal here. It is the Moonlit Savior release day for Force of Will. And we're going to open this bad boy. But before I get to that, just so you know, I don't know if the video quality is going to be off or not, or a little different, as I'm not using my regular camera. I had lent that out to my father while he's away in the States visiting some relatives. So I am borrowing a friend's camera. It still records in 1080p. But I just want to let you guys know ahead of time, just in case. So let us get right to this. Let's get this bad boy open. These are the new boxes that seem to be really, really, really good. Almost like the Vingolf boxes, so you can kind of reuse these. So there you go. Nice, shiny, new, and it just lifts off, and we have a Xion insert, and these inserts are a bit different. They have like a stand, even though it doesn't really stand up too well, it just flops over, but whatever, nonetheless. Alright, so what row are we going to start with? You know what? Let's start with the right one. Did you guys pick up your boxes today, or are you just going to pick up packs? I picked up two boxes, so this is going to be the first unboxing, and then I'm going to record the other one right after this one. All right, first pack. I ripped the point card, but that's fine. This is a really good card, actually. The Executioner. It's an awesome early game card. Just kills things like Lancelot and whatnot. If you want me to read what it does, it's got stealth. So it's basically a chance standby. That's what you're going to be using it as. So, you control a Darkness Magic Stone, and a Resonator was put into your opponent's field this turn. So, when that happens, anytime during that turn, you can flip it, and when this card enters your field from a chance standby area, destroy target Resonator with total cost 3 or less. So, it's pretty good. Yes. Awesome. Okay, so we got Wall of Wind. This is one of the new counter spells. For 1 green, cancel target spell unless its controller pays 1 generic. This is equivalent to, I believe, Force Spike in Magic the Gathering. Pitch Black Moon, Foment of the World Tree, and we've got a Regalia. Oh, sweet. Sweet, sweet. Okay, so we have the Regalia for Alice Idrisil deck. So, Blade of the Seven Lands, Excalibur X. You cannot be targeted by spells or abilities your opponent controls. Your J Ruler and Resonator named Avatar of the Seven Lands Alice you control gets +4/+4. Whenever your J Ruler or an Avatar of the Seven Lands Alice you control becomes targeted by spells or abilities, cancel that spell or ability unless its controller pays 2. So that's just in conjunction with the whole combo. When Idrisil dies, you search for Alice and this and you put them onto the field. Then we have a foil Spacetime Collapse. So for 2 black, choose 1, destroy target Resonator or Regalia, or destroy up to 1 target Resonator and up to 1 target Regalia. Choose the second only if your J Ruler is the Conqueror of the Black Moon, Gil Lapis, or Gil Lapis the Primogenitor. This is an awesome card. This is definitely going to be played in the new Frontiers format. Next pack. Out of there. I'm wondering if we can pull a God pack out of this box or the other box. We will see. I've only pulled 1 God pack out of any of the boxes I've ever bought for this game. Time Traveling Emissary, Nightmare Raiders, Were Rabbit of the Aquamoon, Child of the Forest, Kaguya's Premonition, The Flower Prince, Vel Severian Dragon, Demonic Commander, that's awesome. We got another regalia here in a foil. So this thing is pretty cool. It's kind of like Hypnotic Spectre. Is it Hypnotic Spectre? Or, no. Liliana Spectre, sorry. I'm pretty sure that's what it is in Magic the Gathering. So it's two black in an open. It has flying. And whenever this card deals damage to your opponent, they discard a card. And it's got a 6/6 body, so that's not too bad. Survives things like thunder and whatnot. And it has the evasion, so it can get scary. We have the regalia here for Shion. Heavenly Instrument Hydromonica. So you can tap it, put the top card of your main deck on the bottom of your main deck, or pay two and tap it, banish this card, search your main deck for a card, then shuffle your main deck and put that card on top of your main deck. Jesus, that was a lot of main decks. If you're J/Ruler is Songstress of Shangri-La or Coup d'Etat Mastermind Shion, you may pay one less to play this ability. Discard another card named Heavenly Instrument Hydromonica and draw a card. So that's pretty cool. And Shion seems pretty strong as well, as some people have dismissed her, but I don't think they should. Then our foil is Crescent Moon Magician. So we've got Lunar Ibis, Spirit of Surto, Silencing Spell, Musician of Shangri-La, Ambush. This is a really good card. So it's a chance standby trigger. When a J Resonator your opponent control attacks, you may put a Wind Resonator with total cost 3 or less from your hand into your field. It did some work in the pre-release. And we got another Wall of Wind, which is awesome. I really need these cards because I do want to build a white, green, or I should say light wind control deck with the new Kaguya. Timekeeper Elf, Drill Sergeant, we've got a Darkness Stone, oh yes! And we've got a foil Athena. So Athena, Titan of Revenge, she's a 12 Apostle, which is kind of odd because if you look at most of the 12 Apostles, they're normally like creatures for the most part anyways. So she's got swiftness, and when damage is dealt to you, put 2+1/+1 counters on this card, and then she has the ability to ping both you and your opponent for 100 damage for paying with only paying one red. So this can get really scary, especially later in the game. And it's got a 7/7 body for two red and a generic. So, it looks so nice too, like look at that. I already have one of these that I got in one of my pre-releases, so I'm really happy that I got another one. So I'm 2 out of 4 for a playset in foil. Okay, so we got a non-ugly yellow border Ruck Egg. Really good card. Call of the Primogenitor. Peasant Revolt, Prius, Call to Action, Lunar Ibis, Blazing Metropolis, Velsaveria, Witch of the Night, Foment of the World Tree, a Wind Magic Stone, and a Foil Were-Rabbit of the Aquamoon. So let's read Foment, that's our rare. This is a really good card too, I think. So for 2 green, put any number of cards from your hand on the bottom of your main deck in any order. Then draw that many cards, plus 1, you gain 800 life. That's just crazy. Again, you're probably going to see a playset of these being played in some deck. Because it's just too good. Any dead cards in your hand, sure, just get rid of them and then they replace themselves and you get the extra card to replace this. It's just, and then plus the 800 life on top of that. That's just crazy. Why These packs seem harder to open for some reason. Excuse me. So we have Rhythm of Life. This card is basically Rancor, and it was ridiculous in the pre-release. I had three of these in my deck, and it was just, like, impossible for people to deal with. So it's basically two green in an open, and the Add Resonator gets +8/+8. And then when this would be put into your graveyard from the field, it just goes back to your hand, just like Rancor. The only thing it doesn't have like Rancor is Trample. And then we've got Seal of Wind and Light. This is one of the other new counter spells, and it's a counter spell that can't be chased, so your opponent can't respond to it. So for a green and a white, it's just cancel target spell, but then it has Awakening of One Moon, and that's the ability that causes it to not be chaseable. Temple Monk, Blessing of Athena, Black Moon Fairy, Mordred the Traitor, Heartstirring Sage. Oh, we've got the new Prisha Stone, and we've got a foil Muse, which is a card I'm really excited about, and it's also my second foil one because I got another foil in my pre-release. Oh, this is a full art, actually. Awesome. Okay. So, Prisha, Pursuant of Exploding Flame. She's a beast for some odd reason. With swiftness, target attack, first strike, and for one green, this card gains flying until end of turn. When this card is put into a graveyard from your field, it deals 500 damage to your opponent. So, and it's also a 7/4. This thing, in conjunction with the new, Marybelle, is scary as hell. I had it done to me once in the pre-release, and so you have Marybelle down, and then you play this, you tap this with Marybelle's ability, and then Marybelle gains all of this, but you add the flying to it first, and then tap it, and she gains all of that, and then she also gains the +7/+4 to its attack and defense. It's just, it's crazy. It was nuts. So here's our full art Muse, Celestial of Music. That is awesome. So when this card enters your field, name a card type. Reveal the top card of your main deck. If it's the named type, put it into your hand. If a resonator you control would be dealt damage less than its defense, prevent it. That is the part that is scary about this. And I am going to be using this in my own kind of build, which I'm hoping... It's kind of going to create a lockout for the opponent, and I will make a deck tech for it on the idea, and I'm also going to test it out once the next tournament rolls around here at our locals, and I will also let you guys know how it did. But yeah, that's amazing. So we have Spirit of Cirto, Silencing Spell, Musician of Shangri-La, Another Ambush, Moonbreeze Fairy, Valentina's Resistance, Izanami's Curse, Drill Sergeant. Oh yeah. So we got a foil, Fallen Hero, and Fallen Angelic Destroyer Lucifer. This is my second one. I really need a playset of these for another deck I'm building. But for two black and two generic, it's an Angel Demon 9/9. With flying, then this card enters your field, when this card enters your field, your opponent banishes a resonator. Then you can pay a black and a moon. Whenever this card deals damage this turn, you gain that much life. Play this ability only once per turn. That is nuts. So you play this with Celestial Winged Seraph. So you play Seraph, and then Seraph allows you to find an angel of cost 4 or less and put it into the field. So you play Angel, find this, bring it into play. Now they have to sack a Resonator, or banish a Resonator. And then, now that you have two Angels, whenever Celestial Winged Seraph attacks, you gain, I think it's 300 life for each Angel you control. And then this also has lifelink that you can add to it. It's a crazy combo, in my opinion. And then you can also play Exceed the Light. So, if they were to, for example, kill your Celestial Winged Seraph, you would play that in response, So when it dies, it allows you to search out another card with the same cost. So you just search out another Celestial Wing Seraph. So when it comes in, you find another one of these, and now you have the three of them down. It's some crazy stuff that can happen. I know, I really like that word, crazy, for some reason, but... So we've got Torching the Timeline, Auspicious Bird of the Black Moon, Prison in the Lunar Lake, Wolf in the Mountain, sorry, in the Moonlight, Space-Time Anomaly, that is a really good card. So we got another Wall of Wind, another Space-Time Collapse, Izanami, the Sealed Terror, and a foil, the Flower Prince. So let's go over these two cards, because the one I feel is just an awesome card. So for a black and a blue, or a darkness and a water, Space-Time Anomaly, it has Remnant, so it's basically Flashback. Target J Resonator gains -5/-5 until end of turn, and you draw a card. This is going to be nuts in a blue-black control-type shell. And a lot of people are seeing that, so just be on the lookout for this card. If you get them, hold on to them. And then this is our rare. Well, it's actually a super rare. It's Izanami the Sealed Terror, so for a black and an open. 12 Apostles Myth at a 6/6. And it has these two abilities. So you pay 3 black or 3 darkness and 2 open. Remove a card in your graveyard from the game. Destroy target Resonator. This is wrong. It has been eroded. It is now, you have to remove this card from the graveyard and out of the game, and then you can destroy something. And then the same thing applies for the second ability. So Darkness and a Moon, remove a card in your graveyard from the game. Your opponent discards a card. Again, it's remove this card, not another card. Or else it would just be way too broken if it was that. I guess they must have... I don't know, maybe sent in the wrong art or something when it was being printed, because it just seems odd that they would miss that. Nightshade, Puppet Soldier, Rhythm of Life, Seal of Wind and Light, Temple Monk, Flower Kingdom, Shining Strike, Crescent Moon Magician. Is that a rare? That is a rare? Wow. So we got a foil Moonbreeze Memoria. This taps for Light and Moon. And a foil Timekeeper Elf. So I didn't realize that this is a rare. So for one white, it's a Were-Rabbit 2/6. Or you can awaken it by paying an additional moon and generic. When this card enters your field, it deals 600 damage to target rested Resonator. If damage was dealt with this way, put 2+1+1 counters on this card. So this essentially kills things like Lancelot, etc., etc. It's Lancelot's pretty much the relevant thing that you want to be killing. Wow, why are these packs so messed up? Look at that, I think this is like the third one that I've ripped. Alright, Blessing of Athena, Black Moon Fairy, Dance of Inspiration, Moonbreeze Elf. This is a card to be looking out for. Angelic Wisdom of Cheerdom. This has like pure hate to black red. Like, you awaken it for one moon and it just kills a black or red Resonator. Memory of Disappearance, and that was Witch of the Night. A foil Fire Magic Stone, and we've got an Izanagi, a foil one. All right, so Moonbreeze Elf for one green. It taps to produce a moon, and it can't be attacked while it's tapped. So it's a mana dork that essentially protects itself in some way. You're going to see this thing skyrocket in price. I've already got more than a place out of this, one of them being foil. I'm just hoping to get more foils of it. Then we've got our foil Izanagi, Keeper of the Seal. So for two whites and four generic, it's a myth. 11/11. When this card enters your field, you may remove up to 3 target Resonators and or Regalia your opponent controls from the game. When this card leaves your field for a non-field zone, put those removed cards into their owner's hands. This card gains +3/+3 for each card in all removed areas that was removed by this card. This thing is, it's an awesome card. Awesome, awesome card. Pale Savior, Ruck Egg, Call the Primogenitor, Peasant Revolt, Prisha's Call to Action, Pitch Black Moon, Wind Secluded Refuge, Shion's Hymn, Foil Waterstone, and we've got a Foil Muse. We already went through this already with the Full Art one, but it's still just as pretty. Let me get some focus here. Just as pretty in the regular foil. Alright. So, Servant to the Sacred Moon. Veteran Master. Memory of Flame. Night's Shade. Puppet Soldier. Another Angel of Wisdom. Flower Kingdom. Foment of the World Tree, Light Magic Stone, and we've got a Full Art Izanagi. Alright, this is pretty cool. Let's see what this is like, Full Art. I mean, this one doesn't look too much different in comparison to this regular foil. Yeah, it's got the texture and stuff, but maybe it's just hard to tell because of how big the art is, but it's still awesome. Alright, last pack for that row. So, Black Moon Fairy, Dance of Inspiration, Moon Breeze Elf, Magic Screw, Pale Savior, Heartstirring Sage, Tristan the Knight of Sorrow, Keeper of the Peasant, Present, Viridondi, Disaster's Memoria, and a Foil Ruck Egg. Good old Ruck Egg. Alright, so let's do the first row. Alright, that one was a bit easier. Child of the Forest, Kaguya's Premonition, Infernal Spirit of Velsavaria, The Executioner, Magic Conductor's Baton, Wall of Wind, Pitch Black Moon, Demon of the Black Moon Lilith, that's our rare. Oh my god, we got a super rare and a foil rare in one pack. Alright, let's do this. So, our rare, Demon of the Black Moon Lilith, for 2 black, it's a demon, 5/7. It has an awakening cost of X. When this card enters your field, destroy target resonator with total cost X or less. If you spent Moon to pay the Awakening cost, you gain life equal to that Resonator's attack. It's a really good card. We've got Athena again here. Not foil or anything, but still Athena. Excuse me. Oh yeah, I've been a little bit under the weather the last few days, so don't mind me, guys. Kujata, Sacred Ox. Actually, if I'm not mistaken, yeah, this is, okay, so this is a full art. Yeah, okay. The rares in this set that are full art, they don't have the Force of Will crest in the background. They just, like, do these weird, like, texture things. Like, you can see, like, the ice spike things on it are, like, all foily and stuff. So that's how they did the full arts for the rares. So it's not bad. So for a green and a colorless, it's a Beast 5/5. And it has evolution for 2 green and 2 open. Whenever a new evolution counter is put on this card and target J Resonator your opponent controls deal damage equal to their attack to each other. This did some work in the pre-release for me as well. We haven't seen a ruler yet. This is odd. What rulers are you guys looking to play as? Let me know in the comments below if you have any funky ideas for decks. Alright, Musician of Shangri-La, Ambush, Moonbreeze Fairy, Torching the Timeline, Auspicious Bird of the Black Moon, Holy Moon of Pure Knights, Fallen Hero, Luminescent Bamboo Bullet, Wind Magic Stone Foil, and a Foil Call of the Progenitor. So this is our rare. That's just a foil common. So, Luminescent Bamboo Bullet, destroy target rested resonator. Destroy up to 1 second target rested resonator if this card was awakened. So for white and one open, and then the awakening cost is a moon and one open. So you can 2-for-1 with this. Prison of the Lunar Lake, Wolf in the Moonlight, another Space-Time Anomaly, Seal of Shining Bamboo, Time Traveling Emissary, Izanami's Curse, Heart-Stirring Sage, Memory of Disappearance. Oh, and we have Yggdrasil and a foil Puppet Soldier. Alright, so here's our first ruler. Yggdrasil, the World Tree. Now, this is a ruler that does not have a J ruler side. And what it does, if damage dealt by a card your opponent controls would reduce your life to 0 or less, for the first time this game, it reduces your life to 100 instead. So it's a replacement effect. It can't be countered in any way. Then you may search your main deck and or hand for up to one card named Avatar of the Seven Lands, Alice, and up to one card named Blade of the Seven Lands, Excalibur X, and put them into your field, then shuffle your main deck. So essentially, you can't die when you have all this stuff down. I mean, there are ways around it. You can still remove Alice and whatnot, but again, I have an idea for this deck that's going to make it very difficult to do so. Awesome. So actually, we'll put that ruler there. Call of the Primogenitor, Peasant Revolt, Prisha's Call to Arm, or sorry, to Action, Lunar Ibis, Spirit of Cerdo, Dying Swallow, Blazing Metropolis, Velsavaria, Kujata, Sacred Ox, Light Magic Stone, and we've got a foil, Hung Long. It's kind of a funny name, Hung Long. Anyways, don't mind me. Bad sense of humor. 2 green and 4. It's a Divine Beast, 1,000/1,000. When this card enters your field, for each different attribute among all wills spent to play this card, search your main deck for 4 sacred beasts that shares that attribute and put it into your field. Then shuffle your main deck. This card gains +1/+1 for each sacred beast you control. Will this actually make sacred beasts a thing? I don't know, to be honest. It seems powerful, and we are apparently going to get a slower meta. They're trying to slow the game down, so it is a possibility, but we won't know until we actually start seeing play of decks with this, with these new cards. Alright, Veteran Master, Memory of Flame, Nightshade, Puppet Soldier, Rhythm of Life, Velsavarian Dragon, Pitch Black Moon, another Prisha, Water Stone, and we've got a Full Art, Yggdrasil's Memoria. So we know what Prisha does, we've gone over it already. Great card. And then we've got our Full Art, Memoria. When you control a J ruler, this banish this card. So if you're playing Yggdrasil, it's just never going to happen. You're never going to banish this card because he doesn't flip. It produces a green. And then you can pay a green and rest this card. Recover target resonator. Play this ability only during your opponent's turn. So this can actually help greatly. You can like attack with a big dude and then untap it on your opponent's turn to have it up as a blocker. corner here. Okay, so Seal of Wind and Light, Temple Monk, Blessing of Athena, Black Moon Fairy, Dance of Inspiration, Flower Kingdom, Blazing Metropolis of Elsevieria, Night of the Solstice, Fire Magic Stone, and a foil Wind Breeze Elf, which I really, really wanted to get. So I am super happy. That is my second one. I need two more. Space-Time Anomaly, Seal Shining Bamboo, Time Traveling Emissary, Night Raiders, Were-Rabbit of the Aquamoon, Flower Prince, Velsivarian Dragon, Luminescent Bamboo, Bullet, which we've gone over. Alright, we've got a super rare here, and we've got a foil, or sorry, actually, this is a full art Luminescent Bamboo Bullet. Cool. So our super rare is Keeper of the Future Scald, one fire and an open. She's a goddess 5/5. When this card enters the field, remove the top two cards of your main deck from the game. This card deals 100 damage multiplied by the combined total cost of the cards removed this way to target Jade Resonator. As long as there are 10 or more cards in your removed area, this card gains +3/+3 and swiftness. Again, this is a built around the new ruler. Can't remember his name, Alisarius or something like that. So, I don't know how good that card actually is. Alright, so we got Moonbreeze Elf, Magic Screw, Pale Savior, Rock Egg, Call of the Primogenitor, Velsivarian Dragon, Dying Swallow, Mary Bell, Wind Magic Stone, and a foil Time Traveling Emissary. Alright, so Mary Bell, insane self-aware machine. And you got little Persia hanging out on her shoulder there. It's 5 generic, it has Pierce, 12/12. So then you pay 1, rest another recovered Resonator you control. This card gains +X/+Y until end of turn, where X is the attack and Y is the defense of the Resonator rested this way. This card gains that Resonator's symbol skills until end of turn. So again, it was this, and where is she? She wasn't too far off. Alright, where'd you go? Where did you go? There she is. And Prisha. So you pay the 1. Tap Prisha, it gets +7 to its attack, and then +4 to its defense, and then it gains the flying, if you gave this flying, the swiftness, target attack, and the first strike, and then it also has Pierce, so it's just gross. That's all we need to say is that it's gross. I really wish they would just make these packs like Magic packs. Like, it makes, like, if you don't open them carefully, you ding the corners, and, I mean, most of the time it's a card you don't really care about, but even still. Peasant Revolt, Prisha's Call to Action, Lunar Ibis, Spirit of Surto, Silencing Spell, Flower Prince, Tristan Knight of Sorrow, oh, I think we got another ruler, or maybe a Memoria, but I think it's a ruler. Demonic Commander is our rare, we've gone over this already. And we've got an Orb of Disaster, Ifrit Glass. And a foil, Kaguya's Premonition. So, I've got another foil of these. That foil was out of a couple packs I got in my pre-release, I believe. So, Orb of Disaster, Ifrit Glass. When this card enters your field, remove the top card of your main deck from the game. For 2 red, banish this card, put a non-regalia card from your removed area into your hand. If your J ruler is the Observer, or Timeline Arsonist Alisarius, put up to 2 non-regalia cards from your removed area into your hand instead. Reveal any face-down cards before putting it from your removed area into your hand this way. I lost one game because of this card, because he was able to bring back a burn spell to deal enough damage to kill me. So, Were-Rabbit of the Aquamoon, Child of the Forest, Kaguya's Premonition, Infernal Spirit of Velsavaria, the Executioner, Demon Flame, Fallen Hero, Demon of the Black Moon, another Moon Breeze Memoria, and we've got a Foil Executioner. So nothing too crazy in there. Magic Conductor's Baton, Servant of the Sacred Moon, Veteran Master, Memory of Flame, Nightshade, Dying Swallow, Wind Secluded Refuge, Kajuda, Sacred Ox. We've got a Hymnal's Memoria, so this is the Shion Memoria. We'll go over that. And then we got another foil, Kuya's Premonition. What was he? Did we have another rare? Oh yeah, it was just that one. We've already gone over that one. Alright, so this one. If your J-Ruler isn't Songstress of Shangri-La or Coupe de Top Mastermind Shion, this card enters your Magic Stone area rested. It produces a blue by tapping it. When this card enters your Magic Stone area, name a card. Reveal the top card of your main deck. If it is the named card, put it into your hand. Last pack for that row, guys. So we're more than halfway there. I'm hoping to see a god pack, and I'm really anxious to find out who our other ruler is. Puppet Soldier, Rhythm of Life, Seal of Wind and Light, Temple Monk, Blessing of Athena, Shining Strike, Demon Flame, Thumbelina, Black Moon's Memoria, and we have a foil Rhythm of Life. So Thumbelina is our rare. So for one blue, it's a Fairy Tale 06. Put a support counter on this card, or rest it. Target J Resonator gains +2/+2 for each support counter on this card until end of turn. Then remove all support counters from this card. Again, I don't think this is that good. I could be wrong though. All right, last row. Memory of Flame, Nightshade, Puppet Soldier, Rhythm of Life, Seal of Wind and Light, Angel of Wisdom, Cheridim, Flower Kingdom, a rare Luminescent Bamboo Bullet, and we've got a Regalia here, and a Foil Keeper of the Past, Uther, which is a foil rare. So we have We have Illusionary Demonic Globe, the Earth. This is Galapagos's regalia. So you rest, produce a moon. Spend this will only to play activate abilities of J Resonators. Judgment abilities of Conqueror of the Black Moon Galapagos are gods or abilities of Galapagos the Primogenitor. Then you can rest it, banish this card. If your J Ruler is Galapagos the Primogenitor, put it into your ruler area as a ruler. So this gets you around things like Blazer, for instance. Because even if you have, for instance, Imperishable, Blazer gets around that, still kills your J-Ruler. This gets around Blazer and saves your J-Ruler. And then we have the Keeper of the Past, Uther, or Earther, or something like that. Goddess, 8/8, so when this card enters your field, you may remove up to 2 cards in your graveyard from the game. If you do, it deals 200 damage multiplied by the combined total cost of the cards removed this way to target J Resonator. As long as there are 10 or more cards in your removed area, this card gains +3/+3 and target attack. Temple Monk, Blessing of Athena, Black Moon Fairy, Dance of Inspiration, Moonbreeze Elf, Mordred the Traitors, reprint, Heartstirring Sage, Drill Sergeant, another Regalia, and a Foil Luminescent Bamboo Bullet. So, Interdimensional Vessel Apollo. Your J Ruler gains flying. Produce a moon if you rest it. Spend this will only to pay awakening cost to or to play judgment or God's Art abilities of J Ruler with Kaguya in their name. Banish this card, return target resonator you control to its owner's hand. Magic Screw, Pale Savior, Rock Egg, Call of the Primogenitor, Peasant Revolt, Fallen Hero, Tristan Knight of Sorrow, Memory of Disappearance. We have another Ifrit Glass, Regalia, and a Foil Thumbelina. Really wish this was a different foil rare, but such is life, you sometimes get unlucky. Action, Lunar Ibis, Spirit of Surdo, Silencing Spell, Musician in Shangri-La, Dying Swallow, Blazing Metropolis, Velsaveria, Space-Time Collapse, a Foil Darkness Stone, and a Foil Demon of the Black Moon Lilith. Ambush, Moonbreeze Fairy, Torching the Timeline, Auspicious Bird of the Black Moon, Prison in Lunar Lake, Wind Secluded Refuge, Witch of the Night, World Tree Protector, Foil Light Magic Stone, and we've got a Foil Prisha. I think this is my second one. Wolf in the Moonlight, Space-Time Anomaly, Seal of Shining Bamboo, Time Traveling Emissary, Nighttime Raiders, Shining Strike, Valentina's Resistance, Xion's Hymn is the rare, got another Idrisil's Memoria, and a Foil Seal of Shining Bamboo. So for two blue and an open, put target resonator on top of its owner's main deck, reveal the top card of your main deck. If it's a water resonator with total cost 2 or less, put it into your field. As long as your J Ruler is cooped atop Mastermind Xion, you may pay 2 less to play its God's Art ability. We got 5 more packs after this one. Seal of Shining Bamboo. Time Traveling Emissary. Nighttime Raiders, Were-Rabbit of the Aquamoon, Child of the Forest, Angel of Wisdom Cheridim, Mordred the Traitor, Crescent Moon Magician is our rare, and we've also got a super rare, Izanagi Keeper of the Spirits, and a Foil Veil Silvarian Dragon. Nighttime Raiders, Were-Rabbit of the Aquamoon, Child of the Forest, Kaguya's Premonition, Infernal Spirit of Velsavaria, Timekeeper Elf, Demon Flame, World Tree Protector, Tsukuyomi, Noble, this is our SR, and we've got a Foil Pitch Black Moon. So, she is a Myth Moon, 5/7. Players cannot play activated abilities of resonators they control unless your they control a moon. Excuse me. And then she has an awakening cost of moon. When this card enters your field, destroy target non-moon addition. If you do, put 2 plus 1 plus 1 counters on this card. And she's only 2 light. So it's a pretty good card. I'm happy with that. Got the Executioner, Magic Conductor's Baton, Servant of the Sacred Moon, Veteran Master, Memory of Flame, Mordred the Traitor, Valentina's Resistance, Space-Time Collapse, and we've got a Valentina SR, and a Foil Dying Swallow. Alright, so this is Valentina, the Puppet Monarch, 2 blue, 2 open, she's also a 12 Apostle and a human. 8/8. When this card enters your field, gain control of target resonator your opponent controls, as long as this card is in the field. So they have to destroy this for them to get their resonator back. If, let's say, they take control of this with their own Valentina, you still control the other resonator. I'm pretty sure that's how it works, because it says... gain control of resonator your opponent controls as long as this card is in a field. So it doesn't have to necessarily be on your side of the field. It can be on your opponent's side of the field. So that's cool. Three more packs. Oh, I think I might have given away that I have a ruler there. So Dance of Inspiration, Moonbreeze Elf, Magic Screw, Pale Savior, Ruck Egg, Fallen Hero, Tristan the Knight of Sorrow, Demonic Commander, a Water Magic Stone, and then we have a Full Art Shion, which I am happy because that makes it 3 rulers that I have now. I have Gil Lapis, I have Idrisil, and I have Shion. So, let's go to the ruler side. Her judgment cost is a blue and 2 open. You may look at the top card of your main deck at any time. And then, it's really, really nice. You may look at the top card of your main deck at any time, so she retains that. When this card enters your field, reveal the top card of your main deck. If it's a resonator with total cost 5 or less, put it into your field. Otherwise, put it into your hand. Her gods are, it's called Serenade of Rebellion. For 2 blue, this card gains +5/+5 until end of turn. Then it deals damage equal to its attack to target J resonator your opponent controls. And you can only play it once per game. So it's a one-sided fight. And she's a 900 to 1,000. So that's 1,400 damage to something without incurring any damage to herself. So that's awesome. 2 more packs. Could you imagine if the last pack was a Godart? Or not Godart, sorry, God pack. So, Kaguya's Premonition, Infernal Spirit of Velsavaria, the Executioner, Magic Conductor's Baton, Servant to the Sacred Moon, Timekeeper's Elf, Holy Moon of Pure Knights, Keeper of the Past, Earthener, and Darkness Moonstone. And we have a full art Ifrit. That is pretty cool. As you can see more of the crest, the Force of Will crest in the background there. That's awesome. Last pack, guys. Last pack. Ladies and gentlemen. God pack? God pack? I want to open it slowly. No, it's not a God pack. Not a God pack, unfortunately. Or maybe we can get another full art card. Moonbreeze Fairy, Torching the Timeline, Auspicious Bird of the Black Moon, Prison in the Lunar Lake, Wolf in the Moonlight, Izanami's Curse, Holy Moon of Pure Knights, Keeper of the Past Earther. And we got another Muse, which is awesome, and we've got a full art. Memory of Disappearance. I actually like that in full art. That's pretty cool. Alright. Well, there you have it. We got a bunch of cool stuff. Really happy I got these rulers. Let's hope in the next box I open, I can get the rest of them. Hopefully not getting a third Gilalapis, because I've gotten two so far via pre-releases. But yeah, until next time, guys. This is Mario with TCG Portal. Later. And with flying, then this card enters your field. When this card enters your field, your opponent banishes a Resonator. Then you can pay a black and a moon. Whenever this card deals damage this turn, you gain that much life. Play this ability only once per turn. That is nuts. So you play this with Celestial Wing Seraph. So you play Seraph, and then Seraph allows you to find a Angel of cost 4 or less and put it into the field. So you play Angel, find this, bring it into play. Now they have to sack a Resonator, or banish a Resonator. And then now that you have two Angels, whenever Celestial Wing Seraph attacks, you gain, I think it's 300 life for each Angel you control. And then this also has lifelink that you can add to it. It's a crazy combo in my opinion. And then you can also play Exceed the Light. So if they were to, for example, kill your Celestial Wing Seraph, you would play that in response, so when it dies, it allows you to search out another card with the same cost. So you just search out another Celestial Wing Seraph, so when it comes in, you find another one of these, and now you have the three of them down. It's some crazy stuff that can happen. I know, I really like that word crazy for some reason, but so we've got Torching the Timeline, Auspicious Bird of the Black Moon, Prison in the Lunar Lake, Wolf in the Mountain, in the Moonlight, Space-Time Anomaly, that is a really good card. So we got another Wall of Wind, another Space-Time Collapse, Izanami, the Seal Terror, and a foil, the Flower Prince. So let's go over these two cards, because the one I feel is just an awesome card. So for a black and a blue, or a darkness and a water, Space-Time Anomaly, it has Remnant, so it's basically Flashback. Target J Resonator gains -5/-5 until end of turn, and you draw a card. This is going to be nuts in a blue-black control type shell. And a lot of people are seeing that, so just be on the lookout for this card. If you get them, hold on to them. And then this is our rare. Well, it's actually a super rare. Izanami the Seal Terry, so for a black and an open, 12 Apostles Myth at a 6/6. And it has these two abilities. So you pay 3 black or 3 darkness and 2 open, remove a card in your graveyard from the game, destroy target Resonator. This is wrong. It has been eroded. It is now you have to remove this card from the graveyard and out of the game, and then you can destroy something. And then the same thing applies for the second ability. So Darkness and a Moon, remove a card in your graveyard from the game. Your opponent discards a card. Again, it's remove this card, not another card. Or else it would just be way too broken if it was that. To deal with. So it's basically 2 green in an open, and the added Resonator gets +8/+8. And then when this would be put into your graveyard from the field, it just goes back to your hand, just like Rancor. The only thing it doesn't have like Rancor is Trample. And then we've got Seal of Wind and Light. This is one of the other new counterspells. And it's a counterspell that can't be chased, so your opponent can't respond to it. So for a green and a white, it's just cancel target spell, but then it has Awakening of One Moon, and that's the ability that causes it to not be chaseable. Temple Monk, Blessing of Athena, Black Moon Fairy, Mordred the Traitor, Heartstirring Sage. Oh, we've got Danute Prisha, Stone, and we've got a Foil Muse, which is a card I'm really excited about. And it's also my second foil one, because I got another foil in my pre-release. Oh, this is a full art, actually. Awesome. Okay, So, Prisha, pursuant of Exploding Flame. She's a beast for some odd reason. With swiftness, target attack, first strike, and for one green, this card gains flying until end of turn. When this card is put into a graveyard from your field, it deals 500 damage to your opponent. So, and it's also a 7-4. This thing, in conjunction with the new, Mary Bell, is scary as hell. I had it done to me once in the pre-release, and so you have Mary Bell down, and then you play this, you tap this with Mary Bell's ability, and then Mary Bell gains all of this. But you add the flying to it first, and then tap it, and she gains all of that. And then she also gains the +7/+4 to its attack and defense. It's just, it's crazy. It was nuts. So here's our full art Muse, Celestial of Music. That is awesome. So when this card enters your field, name a card type. Reveal the top card of your main deck. If it's the named type, put it into your hand. If a resonator you control would be dealt damage less than its defense, prevent it. That is the part that is scary about this. And I am going to be using this in my own kind of build, which I'm hoping it's kind of going to create a lockout for the opponent. And I will make a deck tech for it on the idea, and I'm also going to test it out once the next tournament rolls around here at our locals, and I will also let you guys know how it did. But yeah, that's amazing. So we have Spirit of Surto, Silencing Spell, Musician of Shangri-La, another Ambush, Moonbreeze Fairy, Valentina's Resistance, Izanami's Curse, Drill Sergeant. Oh yeah. So we got a foil, Fallen Hero, and Fallen Angelic Destroyer Lucifer. This is my second one. I really need a playset of these for another deck I'm building. But for two black and two generic, it's an Angel Demon 9/9. Hey everyone, this is Mario with TCG Portal here. It is the Moonlit Savior release day for Force of Will. And we're going to open this bad boy, but before I get to that, just so you know, I don't know if the video quality is going to be off or not, or a little different, as I'm not using my regular camera. I had lent that out to my father while he's away in the States visiting some relatives, so I am borrowing a friend's camera. It still records in 1080p, but I just want to let you guys know ahead of time, just in case. So let us get right to this. Let's get this bad boy open. These are the new boxes that seem to be really, really, really good. Almost like the Vingolf boxes, so you can kind of reuse these. So there you go. Nice, shiny, new. And it just lifts off. And we have a Sheon insert. And these inserts are a bit different. They have like a stand. Even though it doesn't really stand up too well. It just flops over. But whatever, nonetheless. Alright, so what row are we going to start with? You know what, let's start with the right one. Did you guys pick up your boxes today, or are you just going to pick up packs? I picked up two boxes, so this is going to be the first unboxing, and then I'm going to record the other one right after this one. Alright, first pack. Oh, I ripped the point card, but that's fine. This is a really good card, actually. The Executioner. It's an awesome early game card. Just kills things like Lancelot and whatnot. If you want me to read what it does. It's got stealth. So it's basically a chance standby. That's what you're going to be using it as. So you control a Darkness Magic Stone, and a Resonator was put into your opponent's field this turn. So when that happens, anytime during that turn, you can flip it, and when this card enters your field from a chance standby area, destroy target resonator with total cost 3 or less. So it's pretty good. Yes. Awesome. Okay, so we got Wall of Wind. This is one of the new counter spells. For one green, cancel target spell unless its controller pays one generic. This is equivalent to, I believe, Force Spike in Magic the Gathering. Pitch Black Moon from Into the World Tree. And we've got a Regalia. Oh, sweet. Sweet, sweet. Okay, so we have the Regalia for Alice Idrisil deck. So, Blade of the Seven. So we've got Lunar Ibis, Spirit of Serto, Silencing Spell, Musician of Shangri-La, Ambush. This is a really good card. So it's a chance standby trigger. When a J Resonator your opponent control attacks, you may put a Wind Resonator with total cost 3 or less from your hand into your field. It did some work in the pre-release. And we got another Wall of Wind, which is awesome. I really need these cards, because I do want to build a white, green, or I should say light wind control deck with the new Kaguya. Timekeeper Elf, Drill Sergeant, we've got a Darkness Stone. Oh, yes! And we've got a foil Athena. So Athena, Titan of Revenge. She's a 12 Apostle, which is kind of odd, because if you look at most of the 12 Apostles, they're normally like creatures for the most part anyways. So she's got Swiftness, and when damage is dealt to you, put 2+1+1 counters on this card. And then she has the ability to ping both you and your opponent for 100 damage for paying with only paying one red. So this can get really scary, especially later in the game. And it's got a 7/7 body for 2 red and a generic. So it looks so nice too. Like, look at that. I already have one of these that I got in one of my pre-releases. So I'm really happy that I got another one. So I'm 2 out of 4 for a playset in foil. Okay, so we got a non-ugly yellow border Ruck Egg. Really good card. Call of the Primogenitor. Peasant Revolt. Prius. Call to Action. Lunar Ibis. Blazing Metropolis Velsaveria. Witch of the Night. Foment of the World Tree. A Wind Magic Stone. And a foil Were-Rabbit of the Aquamoon. So let's read Foment. That's our rare. This is a really good card too, I think. So for 2 green, put any number of cards from your hand on the bottom of your main deck in any order. Then draw that many cards, plus 1, you gain 800 life. That's just crazy. Again, you're probably going to see a playset of these being played in some deck, because it's just too good. Any dead cards in your hand, sure, just get rid of them, and then they replace themselves, and you get the extra card to replace this. It's just, and then plus the 800 life on top of that, that's just crazy. Why do these packs seem harder to open for some reason? Excuse me. So we have Rhythm of Life. This card is basically Rancor, and it was ridiculous in the pre-release. I had 3 of these in my deck, and it was just, like, impossible for people. Lands Excalibur X. You cannot be targeted by spells or abilities your opponent controls. Your J-Ruler and Resonator named Avatar of the Seven Lands Alice you control gets +4/+4. Whenever your J-Ruler or an Avatar of the Seven Lands Alice you control becomes targeted by spells or abilities, cancel that spell or ability unless its controller pays 2. So that's just in conjunction with the whole combo. When Idrisil dies, you search for Alice and this, and you put them onto the field. Then we have a foil Space-Time Collapse. So for 2 black, choose 1. Destroy target Resonator or Regalia, or destroy up to 1 target Resonator and up to 1 target Regalia. Choose a second only if your J ruler is the conqueror of the Black Moon, Gil-Lapis, or Gil-Lapis the Primogenitor. This is an awesome card. This is definitely going to be played in the new Frontiers format. Next pack. This out of there. I'm wondering if we can pull a God pack out of this box, or the other box. We will see. I've only pulled one God pack out of any of the boxes I've ever bought for this game. Time Traveling Emissary, Nightmare Raiders, Were-Rabbit of the Aquamoon, Child of the Forest, Kaguya's Premonition, The Flower Prince, Vel-Severian Dragon, Demonic Commander, that's awesome. We got another Regalia here in a foil. So this thing is pretty cool. It's kind of like Hypnotic Spectre. Is it Hypnotic Spectre? Or, no. Liliana Spectre, sorry. I'm pretty sure that's what it is in Magic the Gathering. So it's a 2 black in an open. It has flying. And whenever this card deals damage to your opponent, they discard a card. And it's got a 6-6 body, so that's not too bad. Survives things like thunder and whatnot. And it has the evasion, so it can get scary. We have the Regalia here for Xion. Heavenly Instrument Hydromonica. So you can tap it, put the top card of your main deck on the bottom of your main deck, or pay 2 and tap it, banish this card, search your main deck for a card, then shuffle your main deck and put that card on top of your main deck. Jesus, that was a lot of main decks. If your J/ruler is Songstress of Shangri-La or Coupe de Tot, Mastermind, Xion, you may pay 1 less to play this ability. Discard another card named Heavenly Instrument Hydromonica and draw a card. So that's pretty cool, and Xion seems pretty strong as well, as some people have dismissed her, but I don't think they should. Then our foil is Crescent Moon Magician.